I've got a 15-year-old who is in the ninth grade right now, and she is taking a freshman biochem course. And you know, she, you know, because we were bad parents and let her watch way too much Grey's Anatomy when she was 12 years old, not realizing quite like how much mature content was in there. Like she, you know, she's just decided that, hey, it would be awesome to be a surgeon. So like she's, you know, she is, you know, just really fixated on science and medicine and like, you know, what does that path look like? And she's in this biochem course and like she's just a super curious kid. And there's all of this material in biochemistry that is inaccessible for a 15-year-old because it's in this scientific literature. It's like, you know, written by people with PhDs. It's, you know, just sort of loaded up with a bunch of jargon. Like, you know, like I was a aspiring PhD at one point who published a bunch of these sorts of papers, and like no one really teaches you how to write well. And so, you know, like this stuff like has all this content in it, and it's not necessarily presented super clearly and certainly not targeted at a 15-year-old. And like the really extraordinary thing that I've seen my kid do and like her fellow classmates is use ChatGPT to go grab a bunch of this literature, dump it into ChatGPT, and then just pound it with questions. Like, explain this to me. Like, I want to understand this. And like, I've just watched for these kids, like how much agency it gives them. So like, they're no longer daunted by like all of this knowledge that's inaccessible. They're just like fearlessly going after it. And like, nobody's making them ashamed of asking dumb questions. And, you know, it turns out that like a bunch of these things conceptually are like perfectly accessible to a 15-year-old. And the economics of that are cheap enough where like every 15-year-old can have this. Like they just need to be aware that, you know, it's inside of the possibility space.